Good morning. Today we'll be doing the Liturgy of the Hours morning prayer for June 29th. Today is Saturday and we celebrate the solemnity of Saints Peter and Paul, their apostles of our church. Let's have that moment of silence to prepare us for prayer. God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia.
I know the one whom I have trusted, and I am certain that he, the just judge, has power to keep safe what he has entrusted to me until that day.
O God, you are my God, for you I long, for you my soul is thirsting, my body pines for you, like a dry, weary land without water. So I gaze on you in the sanctuary to see your strength and your glory.
For your love is better than life. My lips will speak your praise. So I will bless you all my life. In your name I will lift up my hands. My soul shall be filled as with a banquet. My mouth shall praise you with joy.
On my bed I remember you. On you I muse through the night, for you have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice. My soul clings to you. Your right hand holds me fast.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I know the one whom I have trusted, and I am certain that he, the just judge, has power to keep safe what he has entrusted to me until that day.
God's grace in me has not been without fruit. It is always at work in me.
Bless the Lord, all you works of the Lord. Praise and exalt him above all forever. Angels of the Lord, bless the Lord. You heavens, bless the Lord. All you waters above the heavens, bless the Lord. All you hosts of the Lord, bless the Lord. Sun and moon, bless the Lord. Stars of heaven, bless the Lord.
Every shower and dew, bless the Lord. All your winds, bless the Lord. Fire and heat, bless the Lord. Cold and chill, bless the Lord. Dew and rain, bless the Lord. Frost and chill, bless the Lord. Ice and snow, bless the Lord. nights and days. Bless the Lord. Light and darkness. Bless the Lord. Lightnings and clouds. Bless the Lord.
Let the earth bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever. Mountains and hills, bless the Lord. Everything growing from the earth, bless the Lord. You springs, bless the Lord. Seas and rivers, bless the Lord. You dolphins and all water creatures, bless the Lord. All you birds of the air, bless the Lord. All you beasts, wild and tame, bless the Lord. You sons of men, bless the Lord.
O Israel, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever. Priests of the Lord, bless the Lord. Servants of the Lord, bless the Lord. Spirits and souls of the just, bless the Lord. Holy men of humble heart, bless the Lord. Hananiah, Azariah, Mishael, bless the Lord. Praise and exalt Him above all forever.
Bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us praise and exalt Him above all forever. Blessed are You, Lord, in the firmament of heaven. Praiseworthy and glorious and exalted above all forever. God's grace in me has not been without fruit. It is always at work in me.
I have fought the good fight. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith.
Sing a new song to the Lord. His praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel rejoice in his Maker. Let Zion's sons exult in their King. Let them praise his name with dancing and make music with timbrel and harp.
For the Lord takes delight in his people. He crowns the poor with salvation. Let the faithful rejoice in their glory. Shout for joy and take the rest. Let the praise of God be on their lips, and a two-edged sword in their hands.
To deal out vengeance to the nations, and punishment on all the peoples, to bind their kings in chains, and their nobles in fetters of iron, to carry out the sentence preordained. This honor is for all his faithful.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I have fought the good fight. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, if you have some share in the sufferings of Christ, be glad, because you will enjoy a much greater gladness when His glory is revealed. It is a blessing for you when they insult you for bearing the name of Christ, because it means that you have the Spirit of glory, the Spirit of God resting in you. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning, my dear friends. A reflection for today is from the first letter of Saint Peter. The Lord is the head of his mystical body, but the world hates those that are his. And Christ understood this. Indeed, at the time of his crucifixion drew ever closer, Jesus warned us that in this world we will all have tribulation simply because we are his followers. But he also added words of great encouragement. But be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. Christ in union with each of his children, and he feels at heart. He has empathy with the unfair treatment we receive. He understands our pain, for he trod this way before. He warns that we will be hated of all men, and he knows it. It's for his sake that blows and hatred will be inflicted upon his precious people. And yet, we are encouraged to rejoice in our sufferings with exceeding great and overflowing joy, knowing that it is for his sake that we are all ill-treated all day long, for he is the living head of his mystical body, the body of Christ, which is the church.
They gave up their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
They gave up their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
They went forth rejoicing because they have been found worthy to suffer and serve.
For the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
They gave up their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Simon Peter said, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life, and we believe and we are convinced that you are the Christ, the Son of God. Alleluia.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free.
He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David.
Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us.
He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant.
This was his oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life.
You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins.
In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadows of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Simon Peter said, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life, and we believe and we are convinced that you are the Christ, the Son of God. Alleluia. The Lord Jesus built his holy people on the foundation of the apostles and prophets. In faith, let us pray. Bless your church, O Lord.
You pray that the faith of Peter will not fail.
Strengthen the faith of your church.
You appeared to Peter after your resurrection, and you appeared to Saul on the road to Damascus.
Strengthen our faith so that we may steadfastly proclaim that you have risen from the dead.
You chose Paul as an apostle to preach your message to the Gentiles.
Make us faithful preachers of your gospel.
You mercifully forgive Peter's denials.
Forgive us all on our sins.
Let us pause for a moment to lift up our prayers and petitions to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear Lord Jesus, we lift up to you our prayers and our petitions, together with the prayers and petitions of each and everyone who are praying with us this morning. We ask, dear Jesus, that you hear and answer each and every prayer as we pray.
Bless your church, O Lord. Lord, remember us when you come into your kingdom and teach us how to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. God our Father, today you give us the joy of celebrating the feast of the apostles Peter and Paul. Through them, your church first received the faith. Keep us true to their teachings. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for praying with us.
We hope you can join us again tomorrow.
Same time,
same place,
same channel. Have a great day.